Alright, so first clip of this week is right as I'm going to hit 4 million XP. It's not that big of a milestone, but oh, well. Fire ran out. Really? Okay. Just doing some cooking. I did some fishing this morning because it was AFK and I was waking up. So. Oh, come on. It's only like one more fish. And bam, 4 million XP. Okay. Only a few hundred million more to go. Alright, on to the next clip. So I just did Tiers of Guthix. It was only 97 tiers, so I need to get some more quest points so I can go for longer. But I had to get summoning to 30 first, but 8 levels from Tiers of Guthix. That's pretty insane. Probably gonna be doing the. What is it, with Willow Logs, the Beaver Familiar, for a little bit, once I go back to training summoning. But I need to make money now, so either it's time to go skill or time to go slay. I don't know if I feel like dealing with the vampires yet. Alright. So, I did Cash for the second time today. I did Big Chin for the second time today. Still got a little bit in Moss Giant's task. And I did another task in between, I think, too. Oh, the killer watts or whatever they're called. But yeah, just been grinding out some skills. I think I might finish up this fishing at a 62 so I can do Swan Song, and I may do some more quests tonight. I don't know. Pretty soon I'm gonna have to go back to my main account and earn GP for bonds. So I'm probably just gonna AFK and do fishing during that time. And I should update this overlay with the proper total level. Yeah, you'll see that in the next clip. Okay, bye. Okay, hello Zanuck for the first time, and you took an entire set of ham robes that was painful to obtain. Okay. What's next? Oh, I can just yeah, okay. Give one to Zanuck, talk to Dukarush. Okay, I'm going. This is the quest. And that's Death to the Dorgishan done. Gonna go knock out another quest, I guess. And another slice of ham. Though, I did just eat dinner, so I don't know if I could handle another slice of ham to go along with that chicken. Haha! Alright, had to play a game of pest control before I could actually start Quiet Before the Swarm. But, yeah, that's what I'm gonna do now, so I'll be back. And Quiet Before the Swarm taken care of. That's a pretty good XP reward. Probably should have done this sooner. Alright, on to the next quest. It's gonna be finishing. Fur and Seek, which I had already started. I got the quest for it, so I have a few bones. Oh, not a long bone. A few bones taken care of there. Just have to finish it up real quick. And back to more questing. Don't know if I mentioned it yet, but my goal this week is 150 quests complete and around 1600 total. And then maybe going for like a chaotic at the end of the week, if I have the time. Between the paper I gotta write and tests I gotta prepare for and whatnot. Alright. So that's the end of the Fur and Seek quest, which, you know, doesn't actually require bones. Kinda makes sense. Fur and Seek. Yeah, but the bones, you do give him the bones. I think it's a comp requirement. There are even more to collect over time, so I'll take care of that before too long. Alright, on to the next quest, which is Troll Romance. Okay. Now, Ugg and Aga can finally be together. Oh, I didn't know there was uncut gems as a reward. I should eat this. Okay. Cool. And that was a quest. Or in a level. That's nice. Path of the Glow free as well. Okay. Okay, next quest is gonna be Spirits of the Elite. I'm actually like following a sort of guide on this. I'll link it in the description. It's a like level 3 to quest cape guide that someone posted to Reddit, and I'm just following quests pretty much in order because it's pretty nifty. Yeah. So yep, back to questing. And that's Spirits of the Elid done. Alright, next quest is gonna be Monkey Madness. That's gonna take some time. Okay. I can actually do rum deal now too, so that's cool. Alright, on to the next quest. And that's the end of Monkey Madness. So I think I have to go upstairs to get the XP. Yeah, that sounds right. I even had to make full bat wing. Just took like killing, I don't know, 50 bats or something, just so I could do the final boss comfortably. And then training program and attack. Attack and defense. There we go. And come on. There we go. Big XP drop, 110,000. That's nice. All the flashy. Yeah, okay. So I think that's the last quest for tonight. It's getting kind of late my time. Might go AFK some fishing or do something, I don't know. I'm getting kind of tired. It's been a long day, so. Alright. Alright, just woke up and underground pastime. Want to get that Ivan staff and then actually start training magic so I can high alc stuff. And might go in for the rune hatchet before too long because steel dragons are weak to magic. Yeah, and they'll make me some good money through alcables once I can actually high alc stuff. Alright. And that's the end of Underground Pass. Got Ivan's staff. Gonna use that to train up magic a little bit so I can get high alking finally and start making some gold. I think I already said that in the last clip, and it really is early in the morning. Got this Halloween party thing to go to today, so that's gonna take out most of my day. But I'll be back to grinding before too long. And yeah, still working on that goal. 150 quests by the end of the week. And yeah, 1600 total, which is going to be a really big stretch goal, but I think I can do it. Alright, on to the next clip. Alright, there's contact taken care of. Completely forgot to get the quest complete screen, but yep, I've been. Oh. Combat lamp. Another wish. Summoning. Oh, that's nice. Nice. How many do I get? Three? Two. 14k summoning. That's like three levels. That's pretty great. Curse of Arav. It's a quest I want to take care of before too long. And everything I need for desert treasure. Oh no. Guess that one will be coming up pretty soon. Okay, well, on to the next clip. And that's the Temple of Ikov complete. That was really easy for really good XP too. Did that at least give me a fletching level? Oh, gotta get that 52 for broads. I don't know if I'm gonna do broads all the way to 99 though, because that's quite expensive. Yeah. But now on to the next quest. Next one on the list is Zogre Flesh Eaters. Well, I just made a bit of a mistake, but I finished Zogre Flesh Eaters. I'm just gonna throw out the rest of the stuff that I don't need. Not sure if I need that black prism. I feel like I've seen it before for like Morning Zen Part 2. So I'm just gonna hold on to it in case it's the item I'm thinking of. Maybe they just reuse the texture. Throw out the cook chompy. Okay. So I accidentally recorded myself for like an hour and 20 minutes or something that like that. AFKing Artisan's Workshop, doing the quest, and making way too many brutal arrows. And when I meant to press start record to record the quest complete screen, I actually pressed stop recording. So, yeah, I'm just glad I'm recording to my secondary hard drive because my primary, my SSD, doesn't actually have enough space for that. Okay, yep. Well, that quest is complete. Zogre Flesh Eaters picked up the bones from the slash bash guy at the end, just in case I get a idiotic prayer daily. Oh, and I can exit the lobby and log back in to see what my new daily is. One for yesterday was Barbarian Agility Course, which I haven't taken care of yet because I didn't really need the agility levels just yet. Construction, that's really good, but mahogany bookcases is going to take a while to actually get the mahogany. So I may just hold on to that one for a little bit. Don't think I really have a good source of mahogany other than Ape Atoll right now, and I want to do Deadliest Catch before I start trying to collect that stuff. Plus, I've still only got a mithril hatchet on my tool belt, and that would take forever, because I think bookcases are two or three each, maybe four, and that would take quite a bit, like 15 inventories of mahogany logs just to with a mithril hatchet, and then you have to leave Ape Atoll for every inventory. Yeah, I'm just gonna hold on to that, but it's good to see a construction daily. That's probably gonna give a lot of XP. Might get me, I don't know, past 50? Oh, yep. On to the next quest for now, though. Well, I didn't know that Taibo Wanai Trio was such a difficult quest. You actually need 65 fishing if you end up burning the one Corumb wand they give you. Seems like a really bullshit part of the quest. They should really just give you another one and let you do it again, seeing as 61 or 65 fishing isn't a quest requirement. Okay, well, leave that one alone for a little bit and go work on another quest. Whatever's next on the list is let's see here. My Arms, Big Adventure. All right, that one shouldn't be too bad. And I have to remember to pick up two gout tubers, if I remember. That's the quest that gives them. Okay. Scratch that. I can't actually do it unless I have the 1% favor in the cleanup minigame. So I guess I'll do like a Tale of Two Cats and Rat Catchers. Okay. And there's the end of Rat Catchers. I had done the beginning of Tale of Two Cats right before it, so I'm gonna go finish that up real quick. Have to do the little plant potatoes and wait a half hour for them to grow, so I'm gonna go finish that up. I like that this part is called Love Cats, if you right click, examine. They're not separate models, it's just that's Love Cats. I want J-Mods to start spawning love cats all around the world. But that should be the end of this quest, I believe. Maybe not. Oh, not quite. That's all. Okay, this is actually the end of the quest. Not so awkward. I just need to talk to one extra person. Antique lamps. Okay. Herblore? Yeah, Herblore. There we go. Level 50 Herblore. Taking care of that. Irrit gloves. Can't do this apparently. Useless. Okay. Guess I'll do some more quests. Or maybe I'll go do some skilling. I don't know. It's only like 10 o'clock at night, so I have plenty of extra time. I think I'll do some more quests. Caught a random like earth empling or something like that and got a fire talisman. That is a new one. really glad I finally have that because I can make fire runes now. I only have the center six here. I'm gonna get all the rest from what's it called? Abyss eventually, but now I can actually claim like 100 daily fire runes if I need them, or you know, whatever. Just thought that was cool that I catch an earth impling that's going by just for the hunter XP, because it almost got me a level. Oh, I'm getting close to a level at least. And then, yeah. Alright, on to the next clip. Okay, so I just got cooked Karambwan from a, what kind of impling is that? Gourmet impling? I'm gonna go see if this will count for, Tai Bo and I trio, even though I burnt the other ones. I don't think it will. I don't know. I should go see though later. I'm prepping for another quest right now. I had to get Jinger berries for a watchtower quest. It should be pretty quick. There we go. Yet another quest down. 4 quest points. Nice. And that's a lot of mage XP. Awesome. I think I can. Is it this guy? No, I think it's the top of the tower life I could talk to get a mystic staff of whatever kind for gold, but I don't need that anymore because I have Ibn staff. Okay. On to the next quest, I guess? I don't know what's next. I don't know, getting kind of tired though. Might start Desert Treasure if I can actually get all of the items necessary. Yeah. Maybe completing that tonight will be the end of my night. Okay. On to the next quest. Okay, it's a few minutes after the last clip. I realized I can't do Desert Treasure just yet because I need those ice gloves from Heroes Quest, I think? Or Legends Quest? Whatever, one or the other. And I just got 55 magic, which means I can high alk. So that's 155, 404, to 368, 740. Whole lot of money. Just had it piled up in the bank, various rune item drops and stuff like that. Kept a few things that I'll need for clue scrolls, possibly, at some point. So gonna try to keep like one of these at all times. Kinda don't want to put them in the clue loot tab, but that's just what I tend to do when it's an item for dressing up for a clue scroll, so. Okay, don't know what quest I'm gonna do next. If I will do a quest tonight, I might just do some fishing grinding or something like that, because I have to get 65. Pretty sure I read that you can't use pre-cooked Karambwan or something you buy to finish Tai Bo Wanai Trio. So I actually have to cook it myself and manage to cook it with my 56 cooking, so doing fishing and cooking grind would be good. And 62 will unlock Swan Song for me, so I could take care of that tomorrow and then grind on monkfish while I do a paper. So that actually sounds like a really good idea. Oh no, not all feathers. Okay, just gonna go grind for the rest of the night. I might do another little clip, show what progress I get, or maybe the next clip will be in the morning. We'll see. For you it'll be 5 seconds, for me it might be 10 hours. Okay, maybe like 5 minutes after that last clip. Like, this is my second inventory. Got a golden egg. It's my first golden fish egg. Didn't actually know you could get them at this low of a level. So I'm feeling pretty good about that. Just gonna let them start building up and keep AFK. So, first clip for today. It's Sunday, day 3 of week 3. And, bam! Level up to 60 rune crafting. I also got 62 fishing. I did some smithing, so I got a few levels there. I think it was 52. Now it's 56. Been working on a paper today, kind of just having a relaxed day, doing some AFK skills. And I can also afford this now. First upgrade to first extra piece of the Wicked set, I guess. So I can wear that, and that gives me more stuff here. Yep, I might do some more questing tonight. I think I'm going to stick at 62 fishing. I might do some more smithing and just keep doing runecrafting like I have been, because I don't really have any other options for AFK skills right now, and I still have a lot of work to do on this paper. So, just going to head back into RuneSpan, keep AFKing in here, and getting some decent XP. So, alright, on to the next clip. So, here's week two of me completing the statue of Demarok. You can see I was doing some flat packs for construction, because that's apparently the easiest way to get them for construction. And, oh, one per week. Okay, I can't do that until tomorrow. Awkward. Or until the weekly reset, so I guess that's actually like 2.5 days away or something like that. Okay, looks like I didn't have to take care of that just yet. Well, quick update, 1399, so really close to 1400. I don't think I'm gonna put the clip of 1400 since you can already see I'm pretty much there. I got like two or three construction levels doing that, maybe four, and got some more runecrafting levels done. And yeah, probably just gonna go back to RuneSpan. Yeah, still working on that paper. It's really taking a while because it's fairly dull, so I'm getting distracted a lot between like Reddit and whatnot. Okay, back to the or on to the next clip, something like that. Yeah. So just as I get or just as I got 63 runecrafting, I suppose. See, I got 1400 total, and I just done cash, so I also hit 5 mil total XP. Very quickly going through that kind of stuff. I have a question though, since I haven't seen an answer to it on the wiki, maybe someone knows the answer to it. As you get a higher runecrafting level, do you successfully siphon runes more often in RuneSpan? I've read a lot on the XP rates, like apparently chaotic clouds are nearly 100,000 XP per hour, but I don't see how that could be if you get the, well, pretty consistent, just like 2 XP drops whenever you fail to siphon, or fail to siphon like that and it gives no XP. So maybe if someone could answer that, if someone knows the answer to that, it'd be cool to know. Yeah. Okay, just back to AFKing, still writing this paper. About halfway through now, finally. Hopefully it'll get taken care of so I can do my daily and whatnot for long. Alright. Okay, just a few seconds later, I really gotta stop saying alright at the end of clips. Like, oh my gosh. I've listened to myself saying it over and over again. Like, I swear, I'm not Matthew McConaughey. I'm not Outkast singing, hey, I'm just. I say alright too much. I don't know. I'm listening to my speech tropes as I put these clips into Movie Maker at, like, the end of the week, and. Oh man, so self-conscious right now. Okay. That's it, rant over, I guess. And as I hit level 67, I soon realize that runecrafting is now my highest skill. It's actually surprising, as my main account has runecrafting as its lowest skill. Aside from farming, I think. No, maybe. I think farming might actually be lower than my runecrafting on the other account. Anyway. That's 67 runecrafting, and surprisingly, almost 1 million XP earned today, since I just passed 5.2 mil, and I think I started the day around 4.3, so that'd be like 900,000 today. I find it really shocking that nearly or over 20% of the XP on this account was earned in a single day, where the account has been around for 17. I guess that just goes to show that XP rates increase over time, and I think 67 is a certain kind of platform. No, that's 77 is the other platform, and blood runes. Yeah, that's my current goal on here. Don't know how much more runecrafting I'm actually gonna do tonight. I might decide to go and take care of this daily, which is just crafting cooking urns, and this daily, which is from a few days ago doing a barbarian agility course. But I still have a little bit more to write on that paper that I've spent like the entire day working on. Really, it's like a really depressing paper for how much time I've spent working on it. Only like 3.5 pages actually written today, but I guess that's what happens when it's a paper discussing dull topics for like a humanities course that I only have to take one of because of the state core requirements. Okay. Anyway, made a lot of progress today. Also, like halfway to my third wicked piece. Literally every rune sphere that's appeared today on the various worlds that I've been on have been on the top floor. Okay. I guess back to more grinding.
So I'm starting the day off with, well, I did some skilling, but now I'm doing smoking kills. You can see that I'm in the Slayer dungeon, but it's entirely black. I used Auto Retaliate to actually kill the Banshee you need to get the voice, and then kill the final Banshee in the boss fight. Yeah, completely black screen. I mean, I've tried restarting my client over and over again, changing graphics settings, JAGEX please. Oh man. Is that, I think that's the end of the, yeah, there we go. Okay, so now I'm actually getting double Slayer points, which is nice. Earlier I completed the Slayer task that I had, and it was like 30th task complete plus 10 points or something. And then I realized, yeah, I should probably go finish smoking kills and start getting double points. Yeah. So that was fun. I guess. On to doing some more quests. I want to train magic up before too long because, yeah, I want to get a chaotic staff, dragon hatchet. Need to start getting some of that stuff out of the way. Alright.
So I just tried to do troll invasion, and I didn't know if you just right click start fighting, it puts you into easy mode automatically. And then I thought easy mode would have less rewards than hard mode just inherently, so I left after like 2 or 3 waves complete, and it gave me my monthly reward book, which was only like 3.8k herb lore XP. And then looking at the wiki, the highest amount I should have gotten would be it would be 20k herb lore XP. So I was just cheated out of like 16,000 experience because I didn't know normal and hard mode had the same rewards. So I guess that's a mistake on my part. That's also kind of screwy. Like I figured if you right clicked, said start fighting, that it would give you the option of the like normal or hard mode. But apparently not. So I'm gonna go take care of the god statues now. Kind of salty about that. I wish it were more like apparent how to pick the hard mode. All right, so that's the this monthly out of the way. The god statues. At like 2 construction levels and almost a full prayer level. An entire prayer level, I'd say that. One of the requirements for a void dance. Okay. I still got a construction daily over here that I'll have to take care of eventually. But that'll give a lot of experience. I mean, I think this is like 43,000 experience alone. Then you get the bonus XP and the mystery bag to pay back the like 360 planks. So, yeah. That'll be good to take care of before long. I guess on to more questing.
Just got home from university, and that's Eyes of the Glaufrey complete. This quest is like half cutscenes, so everything I actually had to do took no time at all. And that's complete. On to the next clip.
Well, Xanax gone. There's Land of the Goblins complete. That took quite a while for such like a small XP reward. Just like such a little No. It's like two-part 10-minute quest guide from Sick of It. It takes quite a while just to do that little bitty quest. Okay, on to the next one. The Chosen Commander complete. Now that is a good XP reward right there. 20k agility, strength, and thieving. And Xanax, fairly useless crossbow. Oh! Level 48. That might be usable for a little bit. As my current only best ranged weapon is like 40. It's a maple short bow, I think. Here, yeah. Oh, 30. Wow. Okay, yeah. I'll use Xanax bow for a little bit. And maybe different bolts, because those are pretty weak. Got some free Addy ore and the Earth Talisman from that. And on to the next quest. And that's Rune Mechanics done. Really easy quest. Took like 5 minutes. And I get a little pet. Oh boy. Sure. I will keep him as a pet. I don't think I have any other ones other than like the oh, what's it called? Baby troll? Guess I'll just drop him. Oh, and a cat. Oh, but it's not an override, it's a okay. I guess I'll just leave it here. Okay, on to the next quest. And that is the end of. Come on, give me the screen. So much text, I'm not reading. Okay, the Slug Menace complete. Yep, pretty quick quest. On to the next one. That's a really good XP reward, too, like 10,500. Any levels? No. Task complete. Okay, next quest. And that's Heart of Stone complete. Oh, okay. Runecrafting lamp. Magic lamp. Alright, on to the next quest. Just got a summoning level. Because I was supposed to get 2 500 XP combat lamps at the end of Heart of Stone, but you know, full inventory of lobster, that was unnecessary, block that from happening. Just talk to Ariane, she'll give them to you, and a pet override for Kipple, which makes me happy. Oh boy, so many levels up. Okay, on to the next quest. And that's Cold War complete. Some good XP, I guess. On to the next quest. There's the end of Missing My Mummy, and I fully restored the Sinlitten, which is a requirement for can't remember what it's called, Curse of Arav and something else. So yeah, 100% complete down here. Don't need this stuff anymore. And think y'all know what I'm gonna say. On to the next quest. So, there's completion of Observatory Quest, and as you can probably see from my inventory, I'm doing this quest mid another quest. Yeah, I'm doing Spirit of Summer at the same time and currently waiting for the Limpwort root to grow. Should be done by now, so back to the next quest? Yeah. Well, that quest was fairly quick to complete. After I did all the waiting for the Limpwort root, of course. I had to actually go back and make more Spirit Scorpion pouches. Like, I did the first two on the first try, but I made a mistake and used 3 Spirit Scorpion pouches on the desert worm platform thing. So I had to make more of these pouches because I failed the 2 remaining that I had. Anyway, that's out of the way. I don't think I can do Summer's End yet. No, not yet. 55 prayer. Okay, that's done. Probably gonna keep working on questing tonight because, I mean, I don't have many available, right? It's so impressive. Or I feel like it is. It's very nice to see that they're going away. I mean, that's all of the quests that I have remaining. I've done that many. Okay, filter 2, go away. Okay. Back to something. I'm not sure what. Probably rum deal or something, because then I get cabin fever. Sounds right. Okay, On to the next quest. Hey, that quest isn't Rum Deal. No, Rum Deal's next. Did the Abyss mini quests and what lies below. On to doing Rum Deal. And that's Rum Deal finally complete. Going to do, what's it called? Cabin Fever right after. Nice farming level. Really, I tend to neglect farming simply because it takes a lot of time when you don't have good seeds. It's just kind of pointless to keep doing farming. Okay, anyway, time for Cabin Fever.
That cannon is so annoying. Like, it breaks every other try, and I completely forgot to empty
my inventory before going. So I could try it 3 times, which would be chance to fail, it breaks, chance to fail again, then it breaks, chance to fail, it breaks. Ugh.
Drives me crazy.
Anyway, now I have some XP for it, and the quest is done. A task. Agility level. I have access to cave horrors now, wherever they are. I have to get higher slayer level, I think, but yeah, down in here. Never actually fought them before on this account or my other one, so yeah, that'll be interesting, having to grind at a new mob that I've never fought before for a black mask. Okay, on to the next clip. Alright, so I thought I'd give a tip to all of the Ironmen out there that are still having trouble getting this rune hatchet. After you get a decent level of thieving, get some lockpicks and come up here. And there are 3 chests. Right-click, search for traps. Just bring an inventory of some food, and you end up getting food from the chest as well. You get a lot of alkables, and like the 20th... alkable item that I got out of it was a rune hatchet. Not gonna add it to my tool belt yet, because I have that clue that I have to take care of before long. But, as you can see, it's right here. A lot of people may know this spot. It's right by the lever in Edgeville that you can pull. It's south of Edgeville near the dungeon entrance, and it'll take you right here. So, really nice spot. Got the rune hatchet and didn't have to do hours of grinding at dragons. Hell yeah. On to the next clip. Another small clip for tonight. Magic seed from a bird's nest. Fantastic once I actually get the farming level up. Alright, I think that's the last clip tonight. Just gonna work on this daily and go to bed. So, later y'all. Or, well, it's gonna be like 3 seconds for y'all. What am I thinking? So I started the fletching daily challenge that I got. That was like 336 maple shortbows. Completed that between like this morning and the next quest. It was like 52 fletching to start and okay, 56 to end. That's quite a few levels. Got maple shield bows now, so I can do those instead of maple shorts for a little bit more XP. Alright, oh, challenge mystery bag. Wow, that's a lot of magic logs. Okay, on to the next clip. Just a quick clip to show that I did a basilisk task. 10 slayer points feels pretty good. It was from Chaldare, and it's nice that I'm actually getting alkable drops now. I got some water orbs, good bit of herbs, and a mystic hat. It's an upgrade from magic. Along with a rare drop table, 52 uncut diamonds. That's just absurd. On to the next clip.
Just thought I'd do a short clip showing what I've been working on. I did cash and a big chin run, and I'm just doing some AFKing at Divination. I'm working on my other account right now, trying to earn some gold for bonds. Pretty much just going to like kill QBD for an hour with Vampirism Aura up, and then yeah, just come back to this and actually start questing again. I'm going to have to do it on and off over the next 2 weeks, probably an hour or two a day, just to earn enough gold to keep the account running. Like I previously mentioned, I only have membership for a limited time, so I really do need to earn that gold. And then always keep an extra bond on that account in case I need to again. So, Okay, back to doing what I was doing.
Okay, back to making some more actual progress, but I'm gonna cut the clip short because the audio's bugged. Okay, so the audio was just buggy. I walked into this room and it's fine. Summoning daily. Just relogged to see what the daily challenge is. And that's just gonna be make the pouches, get a mystery bag. That's pretty good. Did some AFK woodcutting and fire making earlier, and some more divination, like I showed in the other clip. And this was completion of an Acro's Lament. On to making some more progress. I made like 7 mil on my other account, which I figure is enough for a day. If I do that for 14 days, I have plenty for 3 bonds on this account and a spare one over there, and I can afford the extra food and stuff that account needs to actually gain the money. So, okay. On to the next quest. The museum was finally ready for another explosion to happen, so that's happening now. Yep, gonna go actually place the plinth and the little pieces in my player-owned house now so I can clear up some bank space. Okay, that's Kenneth's concerns done. Some good mining and agility XP. Getting those quest points up there quite high. My main account only has like 300 and something, so. On to the next quest. And that's Hero's Quest done. I'm just gonna give a quick thank you to Voldemorte for the help. They didn't actually need to do the quest, they just showed up, told me to come to a world, and they helped me out. Which is nice, got some good XP. On to the next quest, maybe? The FPS, I mean, FPS is fine, but my ping is really high right now, like 160, even on good worlds. So I'm gonna take a quick break. Hopefully that'll resolve itself, and then yeah, move on to more questing. So I did a cache, I had 68 divination, used up what emeralds I had on necklaces, and made a lot of Sign of the Porter 4s. It won't get me all the way to all of the mahogany planks that I need for this, but it'll get me most of the way there, and I can get some more emeralds from starting to do Slayer. Might have to delay questing for like a day or two because I don't have many left, and yeah, I'm gonna have to really grind out some requirements for more quests. So, yeah, gonna start grinding levels. Already did a little bit of hunter training earlier, very, very tiny bit of thieving, and working on fire making and wood cutting too. Want to get fire making to 60 for U logs for lumberage. Final diary thing. Okay. So, apparently, if you use Signs of the Porter, no mahogany logs will be sent to your bank that are special mahogany logs. You can only get these. I was kind of counting on getting these to pay for the conversion, but well. It's gonna be kind of expensive. I don't actually know if I can complete this daily task now. I used a lot more Signs of the Porter than I originally had, but I might just have to make some more trips back without those and hope for the best, because these are really expensive to convert to planks. So my train of thought here is that each special mahogany log is worth like 20K, or at least like it saves me 20,000 gold. And I need fire making XP, 60 for the lumberage tasks, and then I don't know. Aren't there some quests? I think there are some quests that need it like in the 70s or 80s. So maybe this isn't the best use of mahogany logs, but I don't have the deposit box here for Deadliest Catch yet. So yeah, this is what I'm gonna be working on. I'm also like making money on my other account right now, so it's not completely wasting time. So I've spent almost all of my time today, and I believe it's day 20. I should update that. Just like chopping mahogany logs. I know I'm not getting many total levels out of the way. Probably not gonna hit 1600 by tomorrow. You can see, I set this at like level 61 or 62, and 15% of the way to 75 just off of mahogany. I'm also all the way up to 61 fire making. I got like 10 special mahogany logs earlier, and it's got me most of the way through this daily challenge here, but I just want to try to finish it up, get it out of the way, because it's a lot of construction XP, and I need construction and like fire making and wood cutting for various quests, specifically wood cutting and construction for Plague's End. So I'm just gonna keep working on this for a little bit. Probably gonna go over to either more quests tonight or since I did unlock a few more. But I may just go and train on magic because I need magic for like Recipe for Disaster, Swan Song. I want to get it to 60 for Mage Training Arena and get the 60 free 60 weapon and the God Cape, Chaotic Staff, etc. It's just a really good skill to train. And Camping Crow. I think that'll be like the easiest way for me to get started in tier 70 gear. So, okay, back to more kind of mindless grinding. Okay, well, I finally finished the Mahogany Bookcases challenge that took so long. I gave almost 16,000 extra XP, so 54 construction. Hopefully this is rewarding. Okay. That paid me back like half of what I just spent, so it's pretty valuable. Yeah, I am content with that. Though this reward, I don't know. Okay. Kind of wish that was like 25,000 or something. Maybe I should have extended it and would have like doubled the amount of XP I got. Okay. Anyway, yeah, 66 wood cutting, 62 fire making. Gonna go do some skilling. Need to do a farm run right now. Yeah, hopefully I could do some 1500 total so I can stop being on like noob worlds. Okay, on to the next clip. Well, that was easy. Probably the most pointless quest in the game, and gave way too damn much experience for what it's worth. But I appreciate it. Did I get any levels? Oh, I did not. Well, that's sad. I'm gonna go grind some hunter out since I'm already in this area. I came with my wood camo gear, and I'm trying to get up to 67 hunter for Deadliest Catch. Alright. So I just went and cooked, and I had to do some real life stuff, and I was doing some mining for iron. I came back in, got my daily challenge, and it's crafting green dragonhide vambraces. 300! Pretty sure vambraces require, I think it's three dragonhide. Let me see here. If it'll tell me. Because this is a real. Oh no, it's the first one, so it's only going to require one, but still, that means I have to gather 300 green dragonhide. I don't have a crossbow, so I can't take down green dragons really easily. Oh god, this is gonna take forever. Oh man, I guess I'll just wait till I get them as a task or something like that and collect all of the dragonhide. Okay, well I'm gonna go do some Slayer or something. Just realized I hadn't made a clip for a little while, so I did some cooking. I cooked like all of my trout, which was like 1300 or something, and I did some salmon. Yeah, and I'm doing some dungeoneering now to get magic up, dungeoneering up, crafting, fletching. You know, pretty much everything goes up whenever you do DG. And just remembered, I can go here and claim some free XP for Herbler. Boom. And I'll be at least an Herbler level. Yep. There we go. I feel like I worked on something else, but I don't remember what it was. I guess I did some divination because I did cash. So there's that. Okay, on to the next clip. So last day of week three, I didn't feel like I got much done yesterday, which really made me disappointed. And today I'm not feeling so great. Stomach ache. Hey, look, it's the fucking bot I reported earlier. Let's just do that again. That's fun. Okay. Did some fishing earlier today, till I ran out of urns at least. And yeah, I'm mostly just gonna work on AFK skills today. I still may go for questing,
but I'm mostly just trying to get more quests unlocked. I like to do questing in batches, so you'll notice like I do them non-stop one night, like 10 or 15 of them in a row. And I'm currently trying to get more stuff unlocked. Like I could do desert treasure. I've got all the requirements and stuff. I can get all of the items fairly easily. But I mean, what would I do after it? Like Gower quests and like Death of Chivalry. I like to save like Dimension of Disaster and RFD until I can do the whole thing at once, one go, take care of it all at once. I want to save the World Wakes till I can probably do most of this, or at least get some of the post-quest rewards, like the Slayer lamp at least, or the these right here. I don't have like any skills above 75 or 65. Yeah. So, just gonna work on some more AFK skills. 65 fishing will let me finish Tai, Bo, and I trio. And then, after finishing that, I can do. What was it? I think it was as a first resort? Something like that. Something needed to actually start. Needed 1% favor or whatever in the Tai, Bo, and I cleanup minigame. Okay, yeah. So just more skilling today. Probably won't be too many clips. But yeah, that's the end of week three. Still feeling pretty good about the progress. But feel like I need to pick up the pace a little bit, because yesterday and today are not feeling great so far. Okay. Oh yeah, I forgot to mention the last clip. I also ran out of cooking urns. I need 70 cooking to before I do RFD. So yeah, got a lot of trout and a lot of salmon cooked so far, and a whole lot of salmon to go. But yeah, out of urns, so I'm gonna make some urns now. And I think I'm gonna work on some DG tonight, just because that'll be enjoyable. Train up some magic, because I need 66 magic for RFD and Swan Song, something like that. Okay. So taking care of some hunter training, prepping for Deadliest Catch, getting all the way to 67 is gonna take quite a while here. There's like 1,000 left to go. I'm just like right-clicking release here. Oh man. Starting to get into the real grinds for these skills. So, not sure if I'm losing track of time or what's going on. But I feel like I'm breaking the XP rates that are listed on the wiki. Like, I'm absolutely cruising through these levels. It should be like 60,000 XP an hour or something like that. But I've gotten 40,000 in like an episode, a single episode of American Dad. So it's like 25 minutes maybe for 40k XP. That's, I don't know, breaking 90k an hour. I don't know, I find that interesting. Maybe I'm just paying more attention than most people tend to. Again, though, I'm not really paying attention to time, so don't take my word for it. And I also don't seem to fail much. Like, it seems to be a pretty much catch every single time. They fail maybe, one in 10, a little bit less. Pretty smooth XP here. Okay, on to the next clip. I'm just grinding out XP. About to hit 7 million total. 6996K. There we go. Okay. Okay, yeah, I did just realize I'm losing track of time. I probably watched more than a single episode. I meant to go to cash at that 2300 because I needed another cash for today. But yeah, that didn't happen. Might go to Big Chin right now though, even though it's a minute away, because that'll be some decent XP. I don't know if it beats the XP rates here though. So now that I'm 65 Hunter and I can catch the purple Sophorith moths, in 10 minutes I've gotten like 15,000 XP. It's like five full jars, something like that, and they were all well over 3,000. So yeah, that's an effective XP rate of like 90k an hour. So I'm actually getting 90k an hour here at Big Chin, as opposed to thinking I was at the Salamanders. Yeah, so this is much better. I should really do this twice a day, because every single point that I earn is worth 110 Hunter XP later on. So I think, I don't know, I might bank up enough points to go like straight from 90 to 99 in one shot with crystallizing Grinwalls. Won't
crystallize everything, all of them, that is. Gonna need some Grinwalls for Herbalore. Grinwall spikes go into the extreme ranging potions. But I mean, if you just consider that these are each worth 110 points, just at the very least, that's like 70,000 XP right there, bonus just for doing this. So on top of what I'm getting now, I'm getting a ton later. Which is really good. Yeah. I'm gonna finish this up and then probably make a clip when I get my new daily. So just did cash. Yeah, you can see here, kind of blowing away the boosts. Doesn't do too much for me. Just got two more marigolds to pick to finish the summoning daily I got a while ago. Finishing up a farm run that I actually like started before cash, and then I didn't have enough time, so I had to run. And got my new daily, which is DG. I mean, it's good XP and it's really quick to complete, but I kind of wish it was something else. That's part of the reason I'm trying to get the trying to get the what's it called? Summoning daily out of the way, 'cause that opens up room to get another summoning daily. Okay, just gonna finish this up. Probably go do some DG tonight, and definitely gonna do Big Chin in 20 minutes, 'cause I can do it twice again since the day just reset. Yeah. Okay, on to the next clip. Well, that's 70 divination from Cash. Don't know where the next place is for divination, because I've never actually been that high of a level, I don't think. Oh, I don't want to make two of those. I hope it doesn't. Okay. Whew. Cool. So yeah, wherever the lustrous wisps are, whatever they're called. Yeah, lustrous. That's right. Oh, north of Canifus. Oh, over there. Okay. Yeah. Cool. Okay. Back to Hunter. Because I'm getting really close to that level, and the next big channel will probably give it to me. Alright, here we go. This should be. Yep. 67 Hunter. It's what you need for Deadliest Catch and Black Salamanders. So there's a 60 ranged weapon. Or, wait. 60? 50? I think it's 60. Oh, something like that. And, yeah. Deadliest Catch, which is going to allow me to train woodcutting and construction very easily. It pretty much will unlock a deposit box on Apatol, along with a lot of others around the world. But it also requires 70 fishing, which won't take too long, and 70 thieving. It's just gonna take some time. Getting 560,000 thieving, like 135 at a time from, what's it called? The advanced pickpocketing trainers in the Thieves Guild. And then I might move on to Minifites or something like that. It's something that Alkin did when he first made his Ironman, because they give like 50 gold per pickpocket, and it's also blackjacking. So it's good XP. You do three at a time, and it's like 50 gold at a time, so. Yeah. I don't know. I think that's the grind I'm least looking forward to, but, yeah, just got 67 Hunter out of the way, so that's good. It took me so long to get all of the marigolds for these pouches, since you only get one at a time. Okay, 7.3K, that's pretty nice. Two levels, that's pretty good. Come on. Okay, that's alright. Three rune bars, and my first rune bars at that, right here. Okay, on the next clip. So I just finished a floor, got a DG level, spent way too long because I did all the crafting and clearing and whatnot. But that 68 means 1500 total level. Feels pretty good. Actually, going to leave here now. Let's see, is this. Oh, I can't teleport like that. Just gotta leave. I finished the Dungeoneering Daily Challenge as well.
Hop up here. Oh, gosh. Okay. And maybe that'll end up getting me another level right off the bat. No, I don't think it'll get almost 60k dungeoneering. That would be absurd. I didn't extend it or anything like that. So, it'll be a nice chunk of XP. Get me up to 7.4 million total. And I think this will be the end of the video for week 3. I'm gonna keep doing some dungeoneering tonight, but 47k, so it got me 7.4 million total. Of course, you can see 1500 total level and 136 quests done. One is pretty much done as well. Just gotta get the 65 fishing for the damn Karambwan. Yeah, okay. So, back to DG, end of the video, and yeah.